The number you have reached has been changed.
Someone tell me who is this? Lil Moon, yeah. Hide your wife, hide your kids. Hit my phone, dial tone, I'm in the mix. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. 4.5 weeks out now, so right now I'm getting my breakfast prepared, getting my meal set for the day. I'm gonna show you the diet change that we've made and the adjustments for today as far as how my diet's gonna be going, my eating throughout the day, and then get into some questions for you guys as well. Meal one, got two whole eggs, 180 grams of ground beef underneath, spinach going to put on top of the eggs, my coffee, my meals that I'm gonna be weighing out, and my homie. No. So we're trying to book our flights to Vegas.
Oh, all right, go off. Vent to them about me.
It's less being overcomplicated about the times that we fly in. I went from a 25% decrease in all of my carbs yesterday. Second meal goes from 200 grams of carbs to 150 all the way till Saturday. Same thing for my third meal. And my fifth meal goes from 150 grams of red potato all the way down to 111 grams. So that's what I'm weighing out. 150 grams here of the Jasmine cilantro rice cooked by Fit Fuel Grill. That's what it's looking like. My breakfast. The sauce. This is my special sauce. This one's gonna be 180 grams of chicken. So all of my proteins are about 180 grams right now, which is about 6 ounces. They're gonna make my red potatoes fresh there. Jim. I'm very bad at time management. Is that not a fat dude? My homie's been crashing here.
Shut up!
I don't know how much longer.
Oh, you are the rudest!
150 grams of rice. Swahi. Swahi. How do you ever say that? This has to be a 180 also. And I just reweigh it just to be sure. These are set. I also have veggies that I can just kind of add to every meal. So I missed last week's questions because I wasn't recording. And now I am. So I'm gonna re-answer the ones that people had asked. First one is, how many times a day do you gym? It depends on what you define as like gym. So I do fast cardio in the morning for 30 minutes right now. I'll get about 2 to 3 meals in before my workout, usually two. I do my weight training, and then after that I have 30 minutes of post cardio on the Stairmaster. I know that some people like to do 2-a-days. I'm not a big fan of 2-a-days. The reason being is, if you're not intaking enough calories throughout your day, then you're not gonna be growing because you're just burning through. Another thing is, you know, if your workout isn't that intense the first time around, you know, you should be going hard enough to where you shouldn't have to be going back and doing something else. I do see, you know, sometimes like if you're competing, getting close to the show, then do 2-a-days kind of make a little bit more sense. If you're worried about growing or, you know, trying to gain muscle and you're not eating enough, those 2-a-days aren't gonna benefit you a lot. Also, it just kind of messes up your whole training split on how to do different muscles throughout the week. I personally don't do 2-a-days. What do you think about keto? Is it beneficial? Every form of dieting, you know, is right. There's no wrong form of dieting. It's a matter of what fits your lifestyle the best. The thing about keto is a lot of people like start keto, or, you know, so they think sometimes. It's not so much like just eating, you know, fats, which is like, you know, I hear a lot of people eat, think that they can eat bacon and chorizo. Which is, you know, yes, you can, but at the same time, it's the quality of fats as well. So it is harder after a certain time because you're so limited to what you can eat. Keto is pretty much, you know, 60% fats, 30% protein, 10% carbs. Your carbs are very minimal, which are usually only from like veggies, and that's pretty much it. You know, you shouldn't be intaking any type of rice or things like that. Fats being, you know, your avocado, black beans, any type of nuts. You have your fatty proteins, which is salmon, shrimp, tuna, you know, so those types of fats. Your proteins, you know, being any of your meats, chicken, steak, fish, ground turkey, those proteins. So you're very limited on your options.
But I mean, there are a lot of like creative recipes that you can do. So if you're not one person that gets creative with their cooking or their diet, then you're not really gonna enjoy it as far as actually following a keto diet. Do you recommend having sets with certain rep ranges or every set to failure and why? I do recommend having sets with certain rep ranges. It depends on what you're trying to do. So not every workout or every week is the same for me. If I'm trying to go heavy 1 week, you know, on all of my lifts, then of course my rep ranges are gonna change, you know, from 8 to 12 as I get heavier, you know. So if I'm squatting, I'm not gonna waste my energy trying to get 12 to 15 reps building up to my max weight, because I'm just gonna waste that energy. So I'll usually build up, you know, gradually. So I'll start a plate for, let's say, 10 reps to get warm, you know, and then I'll go two plates for only 5 reps, 2 1/4, 3 to 5 reps. That way I'm just touching the weight to where my muscles are getting warm as I'm progressing, but I'm not over exhausting myself, because once I try to get to those 4 plates, you know, 4 1/4, then that's gonna be my top end set, and I'm gonna try and push however many reps I can there, because I know that's the true, you know, max that I can get. Same thing with bench, you know, if you're trying to see how much weight you can push, you're kind of burning yourself out just building if you're going, you know, 10 to 15 reps. But every week changes. If I'm doing, you know, more volume another week, then of course the rep ranges will change, you know, 12 to 15 reps or a little bit higher. But I usually do failures maybe for like one last set. It's not like every set to failure. And it just depends. Like I said, I make different workout plans. So things are a lot easier in the beginning of a workout than the end of a workout. So if I have someone do push-ups in the beginning of a workout, of course, you know, they're gonna get their top number. But if I tell them, okay, do, you know, push-ups to failure at the end of a workout or after a set, their numbers are gonna be a lot lower. Why? Because they're exhausted already. So you have to kind of have a purpose on why you're doing certain things throughout your workout. But overall, yeah, it's good to switch it up. It just depends on whether you're trying to go heavy, whether you're trying to, and that depends on your goals too. You know, if I'm in the off season and I'm trying to bulk, then I'm going to be going, you know, higher weight with, you know, a little bit shorter rep range, but still pushing some volume as well. How to gain weight for beginners. If you're a beginner, I would just focus on intaking your calorie intake, so your meals. A lot of people tell me, you know, what they want to gain weight, they want to build muscle, and I ask them like, oh, well, how much do you eat? And they'll tell me like, oh, well, I eat a lot. I'm like, well, tell me what a lot is. So they'll tell me like they go out to eat somewhere and they order this much. And I'm like, okay, so like, what do you eat after that? And they're like, oh, well, that's it. I'm like, well, I'm like, yeah, that's a lot for one sitting. I was like, but if you're not able to eat more throughout the day, then you're not actually intaking a lot. So you have to kind of learn how to still eat big amount of portions throughout the day, you know, so 4 to 6 meals throughout the day. So usually, you know, if someone's new to dieting, they're only eating 2 to 3 times a day, I usually start them off with a breakfast meal, a snack, a lunch, snack, and then another dinner. And that kind of gets them used to the 5 meals. Once they're used to that, you know, their stomach will start to kind of expand. They'll get actually hungrier because they'll start adjusting to the diet. And then you start switching out those snacks with actual meals. And then gradually, you know, it's not one of those things to where you just pack on a fuckload of food for someone and tell them, you know, finish this. They're not gonna be able to do it. And anything, they're gonna get unmotivated and it's gonna be hard for them to continue. Who inspires you to dress the way you do? You have a very good fashion sense. Thank you, I appreciate that, man. So the way I get my inspiration is I follow different pages on like my Explore page. I follow a lot of like fashion accounts. You know, I do like dressing nice. I like, you know, changing up my style. But I have to wear certain things that fit to my body and my build. You know, so I do a lot of the oversized tees. I like loose shorts. I'm real big on, you know, ones. I'm real big on shoes because I feel like, you know, shoes can make an outfit, you know, pop out the best. So I follow like an account called Fits on Point, Prime Style Fits, different things. And, you know, sometimes it's just out of my price range, but I'll get those ideas, the color schemes, and then I kind of mix it up on my own, you know. So I'll find different brands that are kind of affordable in my price range. And you know, I'll kind of get those color schemes from there, find similar items, and I kind of put together ideas myself. So there's also a lot of different, you know, places here in El Paso that you can hit up. One of them is Hugo the Juice Man. He's another one of my plugs for my shoes and my clothes. He just got me some Eric Emanuel shorts. I like to be kind of creative with the way that I I put my fits together. I'm at the gym most of the day, so I do change twice a day. So I wear like my normal fits that I wear to train people and, you know, just kind of be comfortable in the gym. And then once I work out, then I change because, you know, that way I'm going to be sweaty. I don't want to sweat in my nice clothes. So I'll change, work out, do my cardio. After that, I'm already drenched. I got a shower there at the gym and then change back into my regular outfit. So I'm going through two pairs of clothes. So I do order a lot of clothes. But like I said, I do like high products. I do like affordable shit too. Fashion Nova, ASOS, you know. I'll be dropping more, probably for the next video. I'll show you guys a little bit more of my fashion style, my sense of how I put my fits together. That'll be another video. I'm gonna put this meal down. I still have my oatmeal and half a grapefruit to put down. Get my meals, head over to the gym, start training, and then we'll get back into my workout. See you guys right now. Getting my pre-workout meal in, 180 grams of chicken, 150 grams of jasmine rice, and some zucchini and asparagus made here by Fit Field Grill. And then I still have my beetroot powder going down as well before my workout. Like I mentioned in the videos before, beetroot powder is meant for my cardiovascularity, my natural nitric oxide. So helps with blood flow during my workout, helps with my pumps. I'm not big on pre-workout, so I usually just take that and some pink salt as well, just to kind of help my pumps throughout my workout. So today we're gonna be doing a little bit more volume work. So the carb cuts in my diet, we're just gonna mainly focus on blood circulation throughout my whole workout. So about to start the workout, we're doing shoulders today. We'll get right into it. That's how all my partners
stars, we hustling, tell them add it up. Bitches off them bars, ain't nothing to tell them back it up. We just tryna ball, these hating niggas, they mad at us. I tell them fall back, fall back, fall back, fall back. Look, nigga, fall back, fall back. You ain't on that, so fall back. Yeah. I just had to breathe, so it's been a minute. Hey, walk up in the building, Florida niggas winning. Ay, word around the city, they say I'm that nigga. Look, Michael Jackson, Thriller jacket with the zipper. Seeing 5-0, I hit a 4-flat. Finesse until a nigga get a gold plaque. And they only show love when the show's back. Bitch, I left you on my past, I ain't going back. Hey, Hennessy, my friend, they say I drank too much. Hey, let me be the reason why you drank too much. Look, chop her to the side, I don't know who to trust. Hey, aim it at the sky, I'm by the way these niggas up. On the shirt, the old time I'm a flirt, slurp me off the perk. Hey, I'm on my mind, I ain't on this earth. Hey, them stars align when you put in work. Galaga, shooting for the stars, we hustling, tell them add it up. Bitches off the bars, ain't nothing to tell them back it up. We just tryna ball, these hating niggas, they mad at us. Tell them fall back, fall back, fall back, fall back. Look, nigga, fall back, fall back.
Today's workout. This is my coach, Freddy. So if you guys want to give him a follow, team_Freddy8. You know, he handles all my nutrition, my training. Been working together for 4 years. It's gonna be our second national attempt. So if you guys are looking to get on stage or just your lifestyle training, you guys can hit him up as well.
So I'm gonna wrap up this training session with my cardio, and that's 30 minutes on the Stairmaster.
All right, guys, so my post-workout cardio, I do intervals here on the Stairmaster.
So I start at level 7 for a minute. After that minute's up, I bump it up to level 10. I'll do a minute at 10, a minute at level 11, 12, 13 is my last working minute, and then I drop it all the way back down to 7, and I complete the whole 30 minutes in that cycle. This is gonna wrap up this training session, and then after this, the rest of my day training clients, and then back home, I'll be getting a little bit therapy done a little bit later on today.
All right, guys, so I made it back home, here with my man Chris. He's the one that's been working with me through my last preps, and I've been getting with him every week when I'm in prep. It really helps with my recovery process and performing better in the gym. So he goes from cupping to scraping, any type of deep tissue therapy. You can elaborate on what you do.
Cupping, simple. With cups, we'll usually do certain movements, but since Richard is more of a hands-on person, we'll use more of my elbow or like little certain movements that we can do physically.
But yeah, guys, you guys can hit him up at CT_performance_therapy, and I'll drop his at right here. You guys can give him a follow. So get a look at how he does things. All right, let's get into it.
Galaga, shooting for the stars, we hustling, tell them add it up. Bitches off them bars, ain't nothing to tell them back it up. We just trying to ball, these hating niggas, they mad at us. I tell them fall back, fall back. So it's been a minute. Hey, walk up in the building, Florida niggas winning. Hey, word around the city, they say I'm that nigga.
It's time to put the mask on.
Alright, guys, so that wraps up today's video. Just finished with the therapy. I'm gonna get my last meals in and then head off to bed. Thanks again, guys, for tuning in. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned for the next video.
The number you have reached has been changed.
And I'm calling my phone. Yeah, no phone with this. Who is this? Someone tell me who is this? Lil' Moon, yeah. Hide your wife, hide your kids. Hit my phone, dial tone, I'm in the mix. Watch a bitch, I shoot my shot, I do not miss. Backwood full of gas, most of these niggas never gonna last. Niggas gone in a flash, but I'm off that, this is off-white if you really gotta ask. Yeah, running it up, you fucking it up, then I'm on your ass. Say I pulled up with the pack, couple